And now I'd like to, before we start, I'd like to tell you a small story, which some of you may already be familiar with. Stan Rogers has written a song about a ship that sank in a storm and about the men who raised her through much adversity. It's a very stirring song and one that I'm sure a lot of you know. Well, on February 12th of this last year, in a storm, a ship did go down. It was the Marine Electric, and it went down on the Atlantic Ocean, traveling north towards Boston. Some of you may have read about it in the newspaper. There was a crew of 34, and three survived. One of the people who survived wrote a letter to Stan, and was quoted on the news here, as saying that the thing that kept him alive was remembering that song of Stan Rogers. It's a song about men's efforts, but it's also a song about qualities of effort, perseverance, and faith. The man is with us tonight. I'd like to introduce him to you. His name is Robert Cusick. He is the chief officer of the Marine Electric. Would you stand up, Mr. Cusick, please? I think the reason that he is with us is not because of the song itself, but because he exemplifies the kind of qualities that that song is about. And it's those qualities that infuse Stan Rogers' writing. And I'd like to introduce now the man who wrote the Mary Ellen Carter and a lot of other songs that have, all of us have taken to heart, Mr. Stan Rogers.
Thank you very much. You can't imagine what a treat this is.
It's really great standing behind the stage there listening to an opening act that's scaring the hell out of you.
Bill Morrissey is number one with us. I don't know how you feel about him, but he's...
Okay.
You all set?
Yep.
Every morning at a quarter to eight, some woman who's my wife tells me not to be late. I kiss the kids goodbye, I can't remember their names. And week after week, it's always the same. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? Woo! And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line.
Yeah.
And it's code in the data. Give the keyboard a punch, then cross correlate and a break for some lunch. Correlate, tabulate, process and screen. Program, print out, regress to the mean. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? Woo! And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. Yeah. Then it's home again, eat again, watch some TV, make love to your woman at 10:53. I dream the same dream when I'm sleeping at night. I'm soaring over hills like an eagle in flight. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? Woo! And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. Yeah. Someday I'm gonna give up all the buttons and things. I'll punch that time clock till it can't ring. Burn up my necktie and set myself free. Cause no one's gonna fold, bend, or mutilate me. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? Woo! And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? Woo! And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
That song was written in 1938 by the chief forestry officer for Antigonish County, Nova Scotia.
Who also happens to be our uncle. That's why we do the tune. Uncle Lee is kind of a neat guy. I have to talk while Jim goes and changes his guitar cord. He went away on vacation. Uncle Lee is kind of a neat guy. He's sort of a backwoods Renaissance man. As well as being a forestry officer, he makes canoes and guitars in his spare time. They sound much the same. He's actually responsible for making Stan's very first instrument. It's a lovely guitar, about the size of my fiddle, and it's made out of 3/4-inch birch plywood. Beautiful guitar.
It is a wonderful machine. The frets, instead of being the normal fret wire material, it's 3/8-inch brass brazing rod. Wonderful stuff. And the original nut and saddle were carved from an old toothbrush. Somebody once suggested that I grow flowers in it.
It's got really beautiful inlay on it all up and down the fretboard, out of mother of toilet seat. It's love that guitar.
Yeah, and then the pickguard is mother of linoleum too. Yeah. It's a great guitar. I still play it. I hang it on the wall of my living room, and I still play it from time to time. I even played it on national television in Canada one night.
All right, go ahead.
All right. This next song, I can see I'm going to have trouble with him tonight. This next song was a sort of a posthumous collaboration. The lyrics were written by the 19th century English novelist, clergyman, and poet Charles Kingsley. The music for this song was written by a certain violinist of my acquaintance.
It was very difficult getting in touch with Mr. Kingsley. We were communicating via Ouija board for a while. And
hey, you've been communicating with spirits for a long time. Three Fishers. Three fishers went sailing out into the west, Out into the west as the sun went down, each thought on the woman that loved him the best, and the children stood watching them out of the town. For men must work and women must weep for this little to earn, and there's many to keep, and the harbor bar be mounted, and the harbor bar be mounted. Three wives sat in the lighthouse tower, and they trimmed the lamps as the sun went down, and they looked at the squall, and they looked at the showers, and the night rack came rolling in ragged and brown. For men must work and men must weep, those storms be sodden and the waters be deep, and the harbor bar be moaning, and the harbor bar be straight dark rose, feel the trickle in your clothes, blow the dust cake from your nose, hear the tractor's steady roar. Oh, you can't stop now, there's a quarter section more or less to go. And it figures that the rain keeps its own sweet time, watch it come for miles, guess you've caught a while and ease the throttle out of air. Every rod's a game, there's victory in every quarter mile. Or a home cause it down the road, the heartache came and hoppers brought him down. Gave it up and went to town. Emmett Pierce the other day took a heart attack and died at 42. You could see it coming on, cause he worked as hard as you. In an hour, maybe more, you'll be wet clear through. The air is cooler now. Pull your hat brim further down and watch the field behind the plow. Turn to straight dark roads. Put another season's promise in the ground. Thank you very much. Interesting to note that here in downtown Boston, Cambridge actually, there's so many people who understand farming. What are you even growing in those backyards? Come on, you lads, draw near to me, that I be not forsaken. This day was lost, the Jeannie C, and my living has been taken. I'll go to sea no more. We set out this day in the bright sunrise, the same as any other. My son and I and old John Price in the boat named for my mother. I'll go to sea no more. It's well you know what the fishing has been. It's been scarce and hard and cruel. But this day, by God, we sure caught cod. And we sang and we laughed like fools. I'll go to sea no more. I'll never know what it was we struck, but strike we did like thunder. John Price gave a cry and pitched overside. Now it's forever he's gone under.
Was my
We've got a lot of songs to get through here tonight. Ready? 2, 3, 4. Where the earth shows its bones of wind-broken stone, and the sea and the sky are one. I'm caught out of time, my blood sings with wine, and I'm running naked in the sun. There's God in the trees, I'm weak in the knees, and the sky is a painful blue. I'd like to look around, but honey, all I see is you. The summer city lights will soften the night till you think that the air is clear. And I'm sitting with friends where 45 cents will buy another glass of beer. And he's got something to say, but I'm so far away that I don't know. Cause you just walked in the door, and honey, all I see is you. And I just wanna hold you closer than I've ever held anyone before. You say you've been twice a wife and you're through with life. Oh, but honey, what the hell's it for? After 23 years, you think I could find a way to let you know somehow. I wanna see your smiling face 45 years from now. Alone in the lights on stage every night, I've been reaching out to find a friend who knows all the words. So she's heard and knows how all the stories end. And maybe after the show she'll ask me to go home with her for a drink or two. Now her smile lights her eyes, but honey, all I see is you. And I just want to hold you closer than I've ever held anyone before. You say you've been twice a wife and you're true. Life. Oh, but honey, what the hell's it for? After 23 years, you think I could find a way to let you know somehow that I want to see your smiling face 45 years from now. Oh, but so won't you? I just want to hold you closer than I've ever held anyone before. You say you've been twice a wife and you're through. After 23 years, you think I could find a way to let you know somehow that I want to see your smiling face 45 years from now. Seeking gold and glory, leaving weathered broken bones and a long forgotten lonely cairn of stones. For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea. 3 centuries thereafter I take passage overland in the footsteps of brave counsel where his sea of flowers began, watching cities rise before me, then behind me sink again. This tardiest explorer, driving hard across the plain, for just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea. And through the night, behind the wheel, the mileage clicking west, I think upon Mackenzie, David Thompson, and the rest, who cracked the mountain ramparts and did show a path for me to race the roaring Fraser to the sea. For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea. How then am I so different from the first men through this way? Like them, I left a settled life. I threw it all away to seek a Northwest Passage at the call of many men, and find there but the road back home again. For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea. Okay. I often take these night shift walks when the foreman's not around. I turn my back on the coolant stacks and make for open ground. Far out beyond the tank farm fence where the gas flare makes no sound. I forget the stink and I always think back to that eastern town. I remember back 6 years ago, this western life I chose. And every day the news would say some factory's going to close. Well, I could have stayed to take the dough, but I'm not one of those. I take nothing free, and that makes me an idiot, I suppose. So I bid farewell to the eastern town I never more will see. But work I'm up, so I eat the dust and breathe refinery. Oh, I miss the green and the woods and streams, and I don't like cowboy clothes. But I like being free, and that makes me an idiot, I suppose. Who've been beaten to the ground. This western life's no paradise, but it's better than lying down. Oh, the streets aren't clean and there's nothing green, and the hills are dirty brown. But the government dole will rock your soul back there in your hometown. So bid farewell to the eastern town you never more will see. There's self-respect and a steady check in this refinery. You will miss the green and the woods and streams, and the dust will fill your nose. But you'll be free and just like me, an idiot, I suppose.
Thank you. Thank you. You know, I once made a promise to myself that I would never write a totally political song. I've often thought that politics really doesn't have an awful lot of place on the stage. People pay an exorbitant amount of money to come out and hear somebody perform.
Particularly in our case.
In our case, yeah. They don't want to be lectured. You can get that at home. But a friend of mine took a little trip to England. It was the first time she'd been home to England in 20 years. Her first day in London, she decided to do a little sightseeing before she went north to see her folks. So she was taking some pictures of the horse guards going through the park. And the car she was standing beside blew up. So a single mother of two teenage daughters is courtesy of the IRA, making with one leg now. I don't care what your religion is or what your politics are or what cause you believe in, which side of the quarrel you agree with. The fact remains that when there are dead kids lying on the ground, all those causes have to go out the window. None of them mean a damn anymore. It's been 293 years since the Battle of the Boyne. I think that's long enough to hold a grudge. This is called the House of Orange.
I took back my hand and I showed him the door. No dollar of mine would I part with this day for fueling the engine of a bloody cruel war. In my forefather's home far away, who fled the first famine wearing all that they owned, were called navigators, all ragged and torn, and built the Grand Trunk here and found a new home. Wherever their children were born, their sons have no politics, none can recall, an allegiance to long generations before. Oh, this sorrow, that name can't matter at all. Or be cause enough for to war, and meanwhile my babies are safe in their home. Unlike their pale cousins who cower and cry, while kneecappers nail their poor dads to the floor, and teach them to hate and to die. Now it's these cruel beggars who spurn the fair coin. The peace for their kids they could take at their will. Since the day old King Billy prevailed at the Boyne, they've bombed and they've maimed and they've killed. Now they cry out for money and wail at the door. But home rule or republic, 'tis all of it shame, and a curse for us here who want nothing of war. We're kindred in nothing but name. For causes our ashes where children lie slain. Yet the damned UDL and the cruel IRA will tomorrow go murdering again. But no penny of mine will I add to the fray. Remember the Boyne, they will cry out in vain, for I've given my heart to the place I was born, and forgiven the whole House of Orange, King Billy and the whole House of Thank you.
which...
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is a 500-year-old ballad written by a friend of ours. He's getting on.
Okay. Briny blood that flows, you've been wounded in the field. She stood in a gown of a velvet blue, bound around with a silver chain. She's kissed his bailiffs once and twice, and three times round again. She's bound his wound with a golden rod, oh, fast in her arms he lay. And he has risen hair and sound with the sun high in the day. She said, ride with your wrinkle down the hill.
Thank you.